Here we go. So, Jamie, lovely to see you. It's been a long
Hello.
time, far too long. I've got my backdrop from my artist residency last year, when Elvis came and joined us on 2 days, came back bearing gifts on the second day. And I've put this up because this was kind of you were just an astonishing volunteer for Middlesbrough Arts Weekend. And that was really where I got to know you. You were down with me at that residency for most of the time. So to start off with, I know that you were the recipient of Volunteer of the Year.
Yeah, it was like Northeast. I think the official title was Northeast Volunteer of the Year in Museum and Learning.
Absolutely brilliant. And can you tell me a little bit about some of the things that you did that led to you receiving that award?
Yeah, so I volunteered at MIMA, which is an amazing art gallery, and they did a lot of really interesting projects. One of them being that they redesigned the toilets upstairs in the disabled area, because one of our participants of one of the sessions said that she found the toilets very boring and very bland. So they came up with this idea, well, why don't we design the toilets ourselves? So we got these tiles and we were making little patterns on the tiles, and then we put them up, and I made this really cool little video about it. And another thing that we were doing as well, at the time we were doing something called the community lunch, where it was about everyone getting together, and regardless of what your status was or your situation, everyone could sit and have a lunch together and talk.
Absolutely lovely. Really, really work. A bit scuppered at the moment, I suppose. And you also had another event that you were working on just as we kind of went into lockdown, weren't you?
Yeah, I was working with the Arts Lab and Creative Factory, and I wanted to do an event that showcased autistic artists.
Yeah, and it's shame. I mean, it happened to a certain extent. You were able to put the call out and get some great submissions in. So that was a brilliant project, and I'll come back to that.
Yeah, I'm hoping now, because my situation, I'm hoping that I'll have more time to prep. And when I was originally started, I didn't know as many people as I do now. And I'm hoping now that I've started to get a little bit more foot in the door, I can make it better than it would have been. So I'm hoping that can happen again.
Brilliant. So, how did you become a volunteer for the creative arts? Have you always been involved in the arts since you were a kid?
Yeah, my original background was in performing arts and musical theatre, and then one day I stumbled across something called streetwise opera, and they were having posters up, and I was doing this meditation class, and we all agreed to do this class, and only I stayed for it, and I ended up getting involved, and then I moved on to the group that had at MIMA at the time, and then I got to know a few of the members of staff. And I was with a company called Changing Lives as well. And an opportunity came up for a placement. And they said to me, where would you like a placement? And I said, well, I really like MEMA. And it sort of snowballed from there, really. And I ended up like, what ended up just being a month's placement ended up being extended, and then ended up becoming a permanent voluntary position.
Brilliant. They obviously appreciated your work then. Terrific. So, do you create any art yourself?
Yes, I do. I do create, and I've just started a BA honours in fine art, so I'm very creative at the minute and kind of doing amazing stuff with that. But I've also had my own little like experimentation. The good thing, whether it's good or bad, was during the lockdown, I just had plenty of time to create things.
So can you tell me a little bit what you're working on at the moment?
So at the minute, it's all mainly to do with my fine art course. So it's like all the projects are designed around the fine art course. So one of the projects was we had to design a 6 foot sculpture that out of paper and masking tape, and it has to stand on its own without anything supporting it. And so that's what I'm currently working on. But I've also been working on like a lot of like little mini projects. Like I'm taking part in the Earth Change project that's happening
The what? Sorry, project.
The Air of Change. And that was through MEMA, and that's where we make videos and things about talking about how our lives and things. So that's what I'm currently working on as well. But as I said, I'm constantly like busy. I try to keep myself busy, try to do little daft projects, and I'm still ongoing with stuff with Streetwise Opera as well. So I'm always constantly busy and always working.
Well, good on you for that. I'm really glad that you're still managing to create. Must be a bit tricky starting a degree, particularly in fine art, where you're kind of having to remote art.
Well, we're very lucky because where we are, our studio, and there's only 7 of us, we're literally in what used to be a church hall.
Oh, brilliant. So you get to be there.
We have once a week, and because it's weird because we have little booths. So without realising it, when they create this little space for us, they've literally COVID-proofed it without realising it was COVID-proof.
Well, what a happy state of affairs. I think that's great. Mm. I was really concerned about how, you know, of all the subjects, art's really something that you need to be there, I guess, you know, yeah. I guess in the technology subjects as well. I normally have this question about lockdown, and actually it's quite interesting that a lot of artists have said it's been really useful for them to take time out to reflect upon their practice and consider things in other ways, but you just seem to be thriving, really. You're still up to all the
things. I think it's because I've had to keep myself busy to stop myself going mad. So I like threw myself into projects to keep going.
That's another question that I generally ask is, apart from producing an artwork like a painting or having a play to put on, the value and the impact that the creative arts has in just in people's lives, even if you're not aspiring to be an artist, even if you're just creating, the focus that can give you, and the positive effects on mental health. I mean, you seem to have, kept up all your momentum, and you just seem like, you don't seem to have been too downtrodden by it. And, it's just really good to hear such positivity.
Yeah, I think I've been very lucky because I've had a very strong support network during lockdown. I've had people who constantly ring me to make sure I'm okay. And, you know, I've had like weekly, daily meetings with people. So it's not as bad because it means I'm able to like socialise, but not socialise how we used to.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, that has been me running clubs online now and stuff. Certainly means that, you know, you open up your audience, and you know, performers had an actor performing live and direct from LA. You know, there's been people that I haven't spoken to for a while that we've all kind of got used to speaking on a screen. I never used to like it. And you know, it's kind of informed my creative practice in various ways. So there are a lot of positive, I think, for the people in the arts. Mm. Did you come from quite a creative background? Are you like the first generation to embark on the arts, or have you?
I think I'm definitely the first one to like be creative as well. And I think maybe as well, it could be also to do with my background and like with being on the spectrum. It meant that I kind of saw the world differently to a lot of people. And I think that's heavily influenced my creativity. And I realised that I would never be an accountant or an architect, but I was very creative. And
yeah, I've the thing that's been coming up, the people whose brains aren't wired to formal academic education or sciences, what part they might have found, what role they might, you know, the self-worth that they may well have lacked if they hadn't have found that the arts is the place for them.
Yeah, I remember reading, watching something where it was about there's different types of like humans that thrive in certain areas. Like some people are good at technical, so they are the, you know, the architects, the accountants, the lawyers. Then you've got us, which are the creatives, and you've got like the workers at the bottom. But every role is useful in society, and I love that, the fact that they're saying even if you just work building a house, you're just as valued. And I like the idea where everyone has a value of some kind.
Yeah, and we certainly learned during lockdown, didn't we, who are the really important people in society that keep us functioning, which are the cleaners and the people who collect your bins. They're the people that we'd fall apart without.
Yeah, it also reminds me of like the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, where they send all the everyone that's like the middle management gets shut off into a spaceship, and then the entire civilization gets wiped out because no one cleaned the phones.
Yeah, it's the Golga Frinchen art ship B, I think.
Yeah.
They send them off on. Terrific. It's been lovely to see you. I hope I get to see you in person soon.
Hope this all ends soon and that we can all meet up in happier circumstances.
Absolutely. In the meantime, just keep on doing what you're doing, Jamie. You're rocking it. Take care, mate.
You too.
Little pip.